Okay, this is the March 21st meeting of the Conway Board of Selectmen. This meeting is being videotaped by Frontier Community Access Television. Is anybody else taping the meeting? No, okay. All right, first items on the agenda, we have minutes for March 13th and March 15th. Has everybody looked over those minutes?
Good to me.
Yeah, they look fine.
Okay, I'll make a motion that we approve the minutes for March 13th and March 15th. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. All right, next item on the agenda, we have 5 warrants tonight. We have a vendor warrant for $410,553. A payroll warrant for $66.67. A payroll warrant for $101,442. A payroll deduction warrant of $3.07. And a payroll deduction warrant for $26,448. I'll make a motion that we approve those warrants. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Meetings attended by select board members.
Well, we went to the incident command training last night. Mm-hmm. I actually haven't looked to see what else I went to, but why don't you go ahead and then I'll
you don't remember the other meetings you went to?
Too many meetings.
Well, last week I went to the Franklin Regional Transit Authority meeting, board of directors meeting, and we had discussions on possible changing some of the routes through the ridership. And also of extending the routes to a partial Saturday, which they don't have any Saturday service now. And also we had a discussion on the possible purchase of a piece of land in Montague of almost 5 acres for a new FRTA transit garage. We discussed the negotiation parts of it, and we recommended them to go back and negotiate a few changes. And nothing was officially voted yet because of that, but we had quite a discussion on it. We were there for 2.5 hours doing that. So.
Great.
Last Wednesday, John and I met with the grammar school at the grammar school budget. We had a budget hearing to look at their numbers and see what we thought. And it's riveting watching. It's on FCAT. And then on Sunday, all of us were at Conway Strong, the fundraiser held in the gymnasium of the Conway Grammar School. Yeah. And what did Heidi say the final number was?
About 4,000.
Yeah. They raised around $4,000.
Over yep. 3,000, certainly, yeah.
For the tornado benefit. It was great.
Mm-hmm. Last night we had the fundraiser down at Chandler's.
Well, that's right. You were at the 5-1.
I was there.
I was at the 7-1, and they reported that the raffle took in a little bit over $1,400.
Which was great. Yeah.
Plus, they'll be getting the proceeds from the dinner and stuff later, but that raffle took in $1,400. I thought that was nice.
Great.
Meal was good. Everybody at 7, it was a full house, pretty much.
Yeah, the food was excellent. Yeah, they did a nice job. And as I understand it, the staff donated their time.
Hmm. Yep, they did. And time and tips.
Yeah, that was great. Okay, busy week.
Busy week. Yeah.
Okay, we have any citizens' concerns?
Yes.
Do you have a citizens' concern, Nelson?
I do. Okay. Yes, I do. Yeah.
Okay.
So, I would like to get on the town meeting warrant. Something that would be called the Conway Sanctuary Community Bylaw, and this would
Sanctuary Community. We've already closed.
Why don't you announce yourself, Nelson, so we get your name in the minutes?
My name is Nelson Shiflett. I live on Shelburne Falls Road. I'm aware of that. However, what brought me here tonight is that I heard on the news this morning that the town of Amherst had just, implemented this program. And I was able to reach out to them and get a copy of the bylaw, talk to some people there and so on. So I understand especially now, having read through all this documentation, that it's just not practical to get it on the warrant for this town meeting. Okay. Had I been able, this is something that I've had an interest in doing for the last couple of months, but I was traveling and unable to do the homework that's necessary to get this off the ground. So I'm here just to let you folks know, what the board know, what my intent is, and to ask for some advice and some direction. It seems to me that this is not an issue, because the cost of a special town meeting, that this is not an issue that requires immediate attention. And it wouldn't be prudent to do that, to have a special town meeting over something like this, especially given that the delay of not having on this warrant is really no one's fault other than my own. I just wasn't able to pursue this, okay? But I would like to make sure that I can get this on as a warrant on the next special town meeting that comes up, or if there is some precipitating event, okay, on a national level, it's unlikely we'll have any local issue, but on a national level, where the town employees are coerced or forced in any way, where the town is coerced or forced in any way, you know, to impose the 287G law, okay, a program where, you know, essentially town employees are deputized to and required then to, you know, to enforce the immigration law. If that happens, then I do think that something like this would warrant a special town meeting. So I made a copy, just informationally for you folks, yeah, of the salient, the important parts of the Amherst bylaw, but there are this many more documents that go along with it.
So do you mean bylaw or warrant article? Or I mean,
I'm saying don't... warrant article, okay. Yeah. To create a bylaw in the town of Conway.
Oh, okay.
That would I had already looked at some of the stuff that went into the cities, okay, and especially in other parts of the country. But when I looked at the amount of work that went into this in Amherst, it was pretty daunting. And it would require the review by the town council, I'm sure, even if we copied this bylaw verbatim, and it might make sense to do that. It would still require review by the town council, and we need to give the citizens, you know, the residents of Conway, an opportunity to, you know, ask questions and educate themselves, so when it does come up for a vote on town meeting floor, that they can make a considered, you know, they have a considered opinion, okay? But I think it's something that it's happening now in Greenfield. It's happening in a whole 300 cities in the middle of January. That number has increased exponentially since then. And I think it's important that Conway, as one of the smaller hill towns, take the lead to say this is something that we want to do in the town of Conway, and to encourage other towns to do the same thing.
So you're suggesting that Conway become a sanctuary town?
Exactly.
What does that mean?
There's a copy of the bylaw here, and it says the essential thing is that it prohibits the town support for a Muslim registry, ensures that the police resources are used to fight crime and not separate families, prohibits the use of local funds to collaborate agreements with federal agents. At the same time, it upholds constitutional standards and conforms to the federal law. And I don't think this is I think this is an important issue. I don't think that this is something that...
So for a bylaw, does that mean it would go before the planning board?
No.
No?
It's not a planning
is that,
bylaw.
No.
It's a general bylaw.
General bylaw.
We may not have an issue in this town, because I'm not even sure that there are any. There are many immigrants, and certainly undocumented immigrants, living in town. But what we need to be cognizant of is that there's a possibility that somebody might be traveling through the town of Conway, okay, and could stop for a motor vehicle violation or something like that. I think it's important that Conway take a stand on this.
Are you saying that you don't think our police should be stopping people for motor vehicle violations?
No. So the way that the 287G program works, as I understand it, and I may not have a clear understanding, is that people in the town's employ, typically you would expect that to be police, but it could also be something, emergency services or whatever, okay, agree to notify ICE if they come across an undocumented, you know.
You mean an illegal alien?
You can choose whatever wording you
somebody
prefer.
Somebody who's in the country illegally.
That's exactly it.
Yeah, okay.
That's exactly it.
And we shouldn't report that person?
Well, the purpose of this meeting, I thought, was conversational. And for me to gather information about how best to proceed, you know, my goal here wasn't to be confrontational. But I absolutely agree. I absolutely feel strongly.
But are you suggesting if we stopped someone on a traffic violation, found them to be here in this country illegally,
yeah,
we shouldn't do anything about it?
I'm suggesting that we should let the citizens of Conway decide that issue. Well, unfortunately, this is not really, if this goes, this is a warrant that will go to town meeting floor at some point, whether it's done with a special town meeting or a warrant in an upcoming town meeting. And after people educate themselves, if the majority of the people agree with you,
you're suggesting that our police officers not uphold the law.
Well, he's asking that our police officers not inquire about immigration status when they stop somebody for speeding.
Well, it had nothing to do with inquiry. It had to do if they are found out to be illegal aliens.
And normally when the police stop you, they don't ask you if you're an illegal alien.
They don't have to. They just send in your information on license and all that comes back to them.
I think that's nonsense. Really?
No, I think it's up for the voters to decide.
So you want the voters to decide to tell our law enforcement officers not to follow the law?
I don't think that that's what I'm saying.
I think that's exactly what you're saying.
So if you would like to see the packet of information that I printed from the town of Amherst, I'm going to leave you what I have here today. I can give you the entire packet. I give you similar packets of information for other cities and towns in Massachusetts and even Hampden County, for example. Or, you know, cities in other parts of the country, you could educate yourself and then answer the question yourself. So that's what I'm saying. So
I think the term sanctuary is unfortunate. And I think because of that, Greenfield is referring to it as a safe city instead of a sanctuary city, and they're avoiding term.
No matter what you call
it. I'm just,
okay, you can call it by any name you want, but what you're basically saying is our police officers, if they find somebody who has broken the law to come into this country, we shouldn't report that.
That's nonsense. Well, that's your view. My view is other than that. And I think that it's a very good chance the majority of the voters in Conway would agree with me. And so I think we need to give them that opportunity.
Okay. I don't agree with that.
We disagree, simply. So how do we proceed?
Just if you can leave the information here.
Yeah. So.
And then you're going to go do further research and...
I would think you'd have to go to a lot further research. You're probably going to have public hearings on a bylaw.
Well,
suggest a bylaw addition.
What you would need to get it on a special town meeting, if the board didn't put it on, would be signatures on a petition. The same would be true for an annual town meeting, except the burden for signatures is much lower for an annual town meeting.
And so the burden then for a special town meeting is?
I believe it's 10% of the registered voters, but you'll have to check with the town clerk, who's the authority on those matters.
Okay. Okay. And so the process then is that I would begin to pull together some more information. Quite frankly, I think that it's going to make sense that we use the Amherst bylaw as a template. It's a town form of government, not a city government. They just did a tremendous amount of research here.
You're doing this solely on your own, or you're going to have a committee?
I'm not sure. I reached out to a few people while I was on vacation and said, this is something I'd like to do. Do you want to jump in? And I didn't hear back. So I may end up doing it on my own, but I would be happy to have people involved. I would be very, very happy to have people involved in this. I don't think it'll be difficult to acquire 150 signatures or whatever. It's 10% of the registered voters, correct?
You'll have to check with the town clerk on the details.
So I don't think that will be difficult. However, the exact wording of the bylaw, if we wanted to make any changes, for example, over what Amherst has done or other communities in the state, then that's probably better done by a committee. So I'm going to reach out to some people in town.
And public hearings. Usually they'll have...
Yeah, so I think it's good.
Public hearings in case you want to take comments from the public on it.
Well, probably, you know, after you get the signatures.
It would be a meeting. This isn't a town function.
Right, right.
Okay.
It'd be a meeting, right. So, open meeting.
So it's
right.
not a town committee right. or a town right. public okay. hear,
open,
it's hearing.
Open
in
meeting,
that
I
sense.
Would say, I guess.
Right. So.
And advertise, you probably advertise it, I would think.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, so I think that would make sense because, you know, it's Amherst prepared, you know, a list of Q&As, you know, that cover most of the salient information. Everything that they did was documented, you know, was in the legalese. So we obviously will be, we don't have to strike out on our own from square one. And, you know, not only is the town of Amherst's bylaw a resource, but there are others that I've also looked at. There seems to be done really, really well. So do we have any idea if there's going to be a special town meeting?
Not that we know of, no.
Well, we've talked about one for the solar panels.
You have? You might have.
Well, when the solar people were here and they apologized for not having their,
but we have
their
nothing,
proposal ready.
We have nothing set yet.
No. No.
Okay. All right. So, or if there's a matter of budgetary stuff, that always requires a special town meeting. Right? Okay. All right. So I brought this information for you, if you'd like to look at it.
Sure.
I printed out three packets, yeah. Okay, and then here's a copy of the 287,
great.
280C. I just printed out one copy of that.
Tom's going to make us copies.
Available.
Yeah. Please, okay.
Sure, yeah. You can leave a copy of, at least one copy with me of everything that you're handing out.
Okay.
Here, you can make it.
This has some notes on it.
Put all together?
No, that's okay. No, no, here. That's right. You can take that one. I don't need it.
A clean copy would be best.
Okay.
Right. Tom, get us all back there.
No. We'll just.
Okay.
And anything you're handing out, we'll put as part of the meeting record.
Okay.
Just give me copies of that back because I haven't got one.
So. Okay. Okay. This one?
Yeah. Okay. That's my copy. You can make copies of it.
Okay. Okay, and if any of you know, if you think that there's a resident of the town who might be interested in jumping in on this, you know, would be happy to hear from them.
Great.
Okay. Good. Thank you very much.
Thanks for coming in, Nelson.
Sure.
Thanks.
I don't know if anybody got back to you, but as I drove around, I looked at all of the, especially the trackers, but all of the solar installations in town after the tornado.
Yeah.
And they all appeared to ride through great. So
none that I was aware of.
So you should be proud of that.
Damaged, yeah. I was particularly, well, there were a few that were, you know, in that high wind area.
For sure.
And they withstood that just fine, so that was nice. Okay, thanks, gentlemen.
Yep. Okay, next item of business. Tom, 2018 town budget and annual town meeting warrant.
Yes, and I have an update from, you all have this Article 2.
Yep.
I'd like to go through that. Along with the warrant. A lot has changed since I developed the budget. A couple of things on the revenue side. We have a little bit more new growth than we thought of. The new estimate is 24,000, which is 4,000 more than we had before. And the budget, as I presented it, does leave $30,332 in free cash unspent as a hedge against contingencies such as those listed below, as well as last-minute increases in school budgets, if we get one for Frontier, and any other higher-than-projected expenses, any unexpected expenses. So we do have some money, just according to the revenue side, that we still have to play with, and that does still leave $23,302 in excess levy capacity. And I am not by any means advocating spending up to our levy capacity. We all know that the budget as presented would add about $1.53 to the tax rate, which is a lot. Mm-hmm. So on the expense side, there are some expenses to be added. I think I mentioned some of these before, but this is really a new sheet, so I'm just going to go through them again. Building maintenance wages would be an extra $3,000. That is now corrected on the draft warrant.
What was the reason for that, Tom, again?
Just a copying error. Same for the highway department. Don't know why I dropped $5,000 from that, but that's been corrected. I believe we should raise the Council on Aging budget $1,200 for foot care, which they used, and we had to take out of the reserve fund this year, so let's just give it to them for next year. And
so that was an actual increase?
Yes, they had to get that from the reserve fund. Yeah. I had originally thought we could save $2,000 because that was for the estimate for borrowing for the wastewater engineering and design. Then that went to the Community Preservation Committee. However, the accountant checked with the Department of Revenue, and they all agree that open space benefits are not central to the request, which is for design and engineering of a wastewater system. So we have before us again the question of possible borrowing, which more recent figures indicate would cost $1,100. And I propose that that would be added under the debt service line item 751 in Article 2, down 4 from the bottom in Section A of Article 2. I will also note that the cost of that line item went down, and it would still go down very slightly under this scenario. So it's for that line item, it's not actually increasing it from last year's expense. So this is a total so far of 10,300 new expenses. However, the Conway Grammar School budget came down $37,562. So the new expenses are actually a negative number, negative $27,262, together with the excess levy capacity of $23,302. This leaves a new excess levy capacity of $50,000, a little over. A general 2.5% pay raise would use $15,000 of that. A 2% pay raise would use $12,000 of that. So that's a little bit new way of looking at how much we have left.
So we've gone up from the 23.3 that you mentioned earlier
to 50,564. And again, not spending all of that would not be a bad thing to do. So there are several notes that we still. We still need to consider. One is that we need final ambulance figures. We usually give them 15,000 in Article 2, but then we also usually have money come from their receipts reserve to cover the rest of their operating expenses. Mm-hmm. And since the last time we spoke, we now realize we need to add almost $900 due to the most recent cost estimate of the new FERCOG radio fees. So that's something to add to the ambulance expenses. As our remaining free cash dwindles, I recommend giving $95,000 to capital stabilization. That's in Article 6, which is now at $75,000, and zero to general stabilization. So instead of the $20,000 I had set aside for general stabilization to put something in, I'm recommending not putting anything in general stabilization this year to help make up for not fully funding the capital stabilization investment, which is usually $125,000. Right. Now, that said, that's an extra $30,000, which is why I said before, we don't really need to spend completely up to the levy limit. We do theoretically have that amount. If we spend it, we would have $5,000 left in excess levy capacity. And that would be pretty much taxing to our maximum. So The place where I thought that that would best come from was capital stabilization.
Mm-hmm.
But there are other places that could come from.
With general stabilization, which you reduced to zero. Anyway, yeah.
Right, and there are other places we could find to fully fund capital stabilization if we wanted to. We still need a resolution for the wastewater article. When it was actually approved by the Capital Improvements Planning Committee, but for half of its cost, because at that point, the committee thought that the community preservation funding was good.
Mm-hmm.
So capital stabilization did approve the concept of the project, but only half of the money necessary for it. That said, we could get some money from capital stabilization for it, though it's at a low ebb right now, that fund.
Mm-hmm.
Since it's not, in the grand scheme of things, all that much money, it's $130,000, I still recommend borrowing that amount, which is nowhere near where our debt level could be and still be quite reasonable.
Mm-hmm.
The cost for borrowing, again, is $1,100. So I still recommend borrowing the money, or putting I still recommend the warrant article proposing borrowing the money.
Mm-hmm.
We do still need a COLA recommendation from the Finance Committee. Yeah. That's why.
When can we expect that, do you think?
They met last night. And
no,
they
we didn't. We kind of forgot to post it. So they're going to meet. I'm posting one for Thursday night. So they're going to meet Thursday night.
And
I can tell
you
the last time we voted on that, we only had four members show up, and so we split and we couldn't come to a decision.
Okay. You think you'll come to a decision on Thursday?
I'm not going to be able to make it this week, so I can't really say.
Okay. Okay.
So hopefully they'll have a quorum. I think they'll have four again, though. But okay. It'll be a different four.
and we will be meeting with the Finance Committee a week from tonight. That's Tuesday, the 28th, I believe, in a joint meeting to go over the budget. We have one more meeting after that, April 3rd, the Monday, to finalize the warrant. So we do need to be prepared to go through the entire series of recommendations.
Okay.
And finally, we now do have the right to farm bylaw included in the draft warrant as Article 23 on page 4. Since it's all new, it's all underlined.
Right.
They did come in and present their process and their changes about a month ago. So
yeah. Right. Yeah.
This is just letting you know that we now have that text and it's included in your draft. So those are the notes on some things that have changed.
And we need to vote on the wastewater article?
Well, right now, it is not. Right now it's under community. It's under community preservation.
It's still there.
They have not
made
that
yeah.
change yet.
Uh-huh.
So it would move from Article 21B.
We haven't voted to put it on there yet.
Oh, I'm sorry. It is on. It's Article 3. I did change it. I didn't take it out of.
Did we vote to put it on the warrant, or did you vote to put a placeholder there for it?
Well, you haven't voted on the warrant. You haven't recommended anything yet.
Right.
So it's still here in.
It's still in Article 3.
Article 21 also.
So I will have to take it out of Article 21.
Are we still talking about budget, Tom?
Sure.
I don't know if you, these other two copies you put in our packet tonight from Gemma and Kenny on the
increase
of the radio procedures.
Yeah, so that shows that Ken did put the final figure from the FERCOG into his budget.
Yeah, I know Gemma didn't and I didn't, so maybe we should increase those budgets.
So you also need the $899. Okay.
$900, might as well call it.
Yeah, yeah.
I need additional 900 and so does the machine, I believe. Because our budgets were presented to you before we...
Yeah.
...other increase.
Yeah, okay.
To clarify that?
Yeah. So that's the sort of thing we can absorb without thinking about it too much, but we really can't play around too much with the larger numbers without being very cognizant of the levy limit and obviously the tax rate.
So we pay this radio fee for each organization,
each
department that uses them.
Okay, is that all you have, Tom, on that?
Just a quick look at this. I have put the new grammar school operating costs into the draft warrant under Section B.
Right.
The numbers as we got them, if you still have the budget document from the school committee meeting,
right. That
presents both the operating and the transportation budgets together. So the figure is that 1.7 and the 77,000 added together. That's why these figures look different from the one that's in the...
This is the new grammar school operating budget. Did you talk about last week with them? Is that the new figure?
This is the one that the grammar school voted after the last budget here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the reason it doesn't look the same is you have to add the transportation to it to come up to the total.
Yeah.
They don't break it out. Traditionally, we have.
Yeah. We got a revised budget when we were there last Wednesday.
That's just dollar amount.
Yes, and that is this dollar amount, yes.
And several times in that meeting, they talked about this lowered the increase down to this $52,000 that you see.
Yep. It had been 89.
Right.
So for now, I will just propose that we do zero out general stabilization and make the, which is Article 10, and add that 20,000 to Article 6 capital stabilization. General stabilization is very healthy. It's over $400,000. Capital stabilization is down to under $200,000. So the more we can put into capital stabilization, the better.
Okay. All right. We're not restricted in what we can do with these funds.
Well, a couple of these budgets, we had some hefty increases in a couple of the budget line item budgets, didn't we? Due to specific people wanting substantial raises in pay this year? Not yours, but
some,
I mean...
Some, not like...
One or two of them, right?
Not like $20,000.
That we haven't discussed yet either, so...
Well, we did discuss it during the budget hearings, but we'll go over each of the line items again.
All right, so next Tuesday we're meeting with finance, and we should pretty much have this wrapped up by then.
A week from Tuesday, it would be great if the entire warrant were done with all your recommendations on all of the articles.
Okay.
The finance committee will just make recommendations about the money articles and Article 2.
So two weeks from last night, it should be.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And we could also take some money from general stabilization and put it into capital stabilization to bring it up, $30,000, to bring it back up to its traditional $125,000 level. That's another thing that I would offer for your consideration. Again, we have lots of money in general stabilization. We clearly have the need for capital stabilization money. It is at a low ebb at this point. And so that would be one way of keeping the momentum going in capital stabilization. It's not a long-term solution because it's just robbing Peter to pay Paul, but it does keep us investing in it at a time when it's not that hard. It's $30,000. And it's something to consider as we go through. We can talk about that with the finance committee as well.
Yeah. Is there a different?
I don't see a big deal doing that because we can use general or capital stabilization for anything we want.
Right.
Yes.
Is there an advantage in adding that $30,000, which we have without having an override, so that the levy is $30,000 higher next year?
No, it wouldn't affect that.
It wouldn't, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so 2 weeks from last night, we should have this finalized then.
So we don't need to vote on this now?
No.
But you just...
No, but be prepared to talk about all of the money articles
next week.
Yeah. And after the meeting with the Finance Committee, if we can go through the rest of them, see if we can get a... And because I plug in, after where it says Board of Selectmen recommendation, I plug in 3-0, 2-1, 0-3.
And when do we vote on that, next week?
Whatever it is. It should be completed by a week from... 2 weeks from yesterday. You can manage it however you like, but earlier is always good.
Okay. Thank you, Tom.
You're welcome.
Okay, next item is to discuss the selection of the resident for the town report dedication. I understand that our town clerk has indicated that she thinks that Richard Dacey should be the person the town report is dedicated to.
That is her report. That is her recommendation.
Does anyone have any other recommendation?
There were a number of people who died in the last year that I thought were worthy. And, I'm a big fan of Jerry Sama. Mm-hmm. But I think Dick Dacey is...
Dick Dacey dedicated his whole life to the town of Conway.
Absolutely, right. Absolutely.
Whether it was on the cemetery committee, whether it was years as a teacher, many years as principal, you don't think you'd find anybody that's dedicated himself to the town of Conway more than he has.
I also was a big fan of Bob Corris, but...
Yes.
Bob was in and out, too. I mean,
yeah.
He came back in more recent years in a very small manner, but Dick was...
Yeah.
But to the day he died, he was still dedicating himself to town accounting.
So we're more or less
I'll make a motion that
agreed.
We approve Dick Dacey.
I'll second that.
All aye. In favor?
Sure. All in favor?
Yeah, aye.
Okay. Dick Dacey is the one to have the town report dedicated. By the way, I am working on a draft of the town report, and I hopefully will finish it up this weekend, along with the thank you letters. For all the people that we want, so that we can all sign those letters and send them out. As I say, I've been working on those things.
In your spare time?
Yeah, in my spare time. And hopefully I will have all of that by next Tuesday's meeting.
You asked me about those Boy Scouts.
Oh, the Boy Scouts, right.
That's all I got an answer back, was there's the address and just its first two names only.
Okay, could you just forward that to me? Forward that to my email? Thanks. And I'll add them to the list. Thank you letter list. Okay. Got those two things that... All right, so that's done. Items not anticipated within 48 hours of the meeting, Tom?
Nothing.
Okay, good. Do you have an update for us, Tom?
I do.
You got it, Tom.
For committee work, the Energy Committee has pushed through all remaining barriers to work on insulating the town hall. Since we expect some cost savings from the new, less ambitious design, the engineer is making some calculations about possible energy savings for insulating the roof of the town garage. On tornado-related work, for the $50,000 insurance check to the UCC and the town, town council suggests setting up a joint account with the church. Expenses would be approved by both parties, in the town's case, presumably the historical commission, because it's... The idea is that they shouldn't do any work that is going to harm the historicity of the building. During the tornado relief fundraiser at the Conway Grammar School, we were able to identify another dozen or so damage areas by having people put stickers on a laminated map after comparing it to a map of known damage. Lee Whitcomb will have these areas entered into the main map to get us a full understanding of the damage. And we'll also have that map available at the Woodland Restoration meeting a week from tomorrow night, which should probably be under announcements. I have been, departments, I have been working a lot on disability compliance. The town's application to be part of the Community Development Block Grant requires us to have a plan in place either for compliance with the Americans with Disabilities Act or a transition plan for compliance, including a self-assessment. I'm looking for other towns' transition plans, but I'm forging ahead anyway. I have not gotten a transition plan yet. Also, there is a window for grants for planning and projects. I'm trying to get through the documentation that would allow us to apply for a project grant, but at least we'll apply for a planning grant. I'm also catching up on current community compact work. I will be meeting with Joe Markarian for long-term financial planning and with Northeast IT for the best IT practices piece, both of which are nearing completion.
Great. Thank you, Tom. Okay, concerns of the selectmen. Do we have any concerns? No concerns. This is good. Okay. Tom, this sheet in our folder's roundtable conversation.
That's an announcement. Yeah.
Is what he's going to cover that morning?
This is about Senator Hines coming.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. That's good to know. Thank you.
That's great. Okay. That's next
Tuesday morning
from today. In the town hall.
And good. We'll have that in the general purpose room so that it's accessible.
Yeah. Good idea.
Bathroom accessibility.
Pretty close. Let's see, mail. What do we get in the mail here? Stand Up for Transportation Day, April 10th. Town of Conway.
Oh, Bob might want to look at that, actually, as FRTA representative. Mm-hmm. They might have mentioned that
in
your meeting.
Okay.
It is communications lore that you have to touch someone with a communication 7 times before they'll actually do something about it. So this is 2.
Somebody did a study that said that?
Yeah.
At least 5 times. Mm. Feasibility study for expansion of Shelburne Control dispatching services. This is from FERCOG.
And we will be hearing more from them. This is a heads up.
Right.
If you want to read it, it's they're going to be asking for the town to sign on to a letter of support for a feasibility study, which is not going to cost any money.
Right.
So Shelburne Control, is that Phil Gilmore? Or
No. That's the state police.
The Franklin County Sheriff's Office and the Greater Police Department are heading this up.
I see.
They're spearheading this conversation. They're looking into the expansion of it. Feasibility for expansion of Shelburne Control Dispatching Center.
Just to include Greenfield and Montague.
Oh, great.
Better radios.
Well, we got these dispatch tests all over the county. Mm-hmm. There's nothing better than putting them on in spot.
We've got the invitation to attend the rescheduled public hearing and meeting of the Frontier Regional School Committee to discuss the fiscal 2018 budget at Frontier. That's tomorrow night at 6:00. However, someone was telling me there's a meeting at 5:00 that we should also be.
Well, that's just their regular board member at 6:00. They're going to start discussing the budgets.
Okay.
Are you going?
I am, but I thought it was 5:00. I mean, maybe from John.
I'm
wouldn't want to show up at 6:00 and have the 5:00 budget hearing be over.
I'm gonna try to be there at 5:00.
I have that tomorrow night's my normal commitment. Wednesday
night, yeah. Fire meeting. So
if you guys could stand in for me, I'd appreciate it.
Oh, absolutely.
Keep on fighting.
Oh.
You did a good job last week, so
absolutely.
You can watch it on FCAT video on demand.
There's gonna be an official opening ceremony of the Franklin County Justice Center, also known as the courthouse. That's on Friday, April 7th at 2 p.m. And it looks like the governor and the lieutenant governor may be there. Or maybe they're just...
Sounds like
their names are on there. But it looks like they could be there.
They probably won't know until the day itself.
Probably.
Great.
So this isn't exactly mail, perhaps an announcement, but at 7:30 today, immediately after this meeting, there's a good presentation at the Historical Commission down the street by Jeremy Rogers, who used to live here in town. And Jeremy has written a book about Western Massachusetts, and it's titled something like The Last 150,000 Years of Development or something like that. And but
18,000 years
of
Conway history.
That's it. That's
so. 18,000 years. That's going back quite a while.
So he's
going
to do it in an hour and a
that's
half.
That's before but, Bob Baker here. Robert.
Just a couple days
before.
Just.
I have gone through some of Jeremy's book, which is excellent. And you might enjoy his talk at 7:30.
Well, we're gonna be out of here in 2 seconds. We have any announcements? No. Okay. Next scheduled meeting is for Tuesday, March 28th. Primarily, and it's on Tuesday again next week, so Bob and I can attend the Incident Command System next course at Turner's Falls.
Bob, we really enjoyed the first class yesterday. It was a little dry, but it was good to have done. It was good to have done this right after the incident here, and you could sort of see all of the pieces he talked about, all where they had happened or maybe didn't happen. But
it's organization nomenclature.
Yeah,
that's what it's
about. Yeah.
The way we've done this in the past is the select board has its meeting at 6:00, then we meet with the finance committee at 6:30. I think that'll be a good thing. And if there is not a lot on the agenda, I think there are some things on the agenda for 6, but if there's not a lot, maybe we can start going through some of the non-financial items and have select board recommendations including those in the warrant.
Yep, good idea.
Good idea.
Okay, if there's no other business to come before the board, I'll make a motion that we adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.